Hello, how are you?
I'm very good. How are you?
Good, thank you. What is your name?
My name is Ling. What's your name?
Lynn, nice to meet you. My name is Kyle.
Kyle, nice to meet you too. Where are you from?
I'm from the United States, from Seattle. And you?
I'm from Vietnam. Do you know Vietnam?
Vietnam, cool. Yes, I was in Vietnam last year for 2 weeks.
Oh, really?
I loved Vietnam.
Yeah. So which place that you visited Vietnam?
In Vietnam, I visited Saigon, Ho Chi Minh City, and Mui
Oh, right. Mui Ne. Okay, I will write it and it's right like this.
Excuse me.
It's
Okay. Yes,
okay.
Mui Ne, like that.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's very beautiful. I visited once. Yeah.
They have some nice beaches in Mui Ne and those sand dunes. I really like the sand dunes.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Do you go to university?
Right now?
No, let's have you go to university before, or you graduate from university.
Yes, I graduated from the university. Now I'm a teacher.
Yeah,
What
so
about you?
for me right now, I'm just in secondary school.
Okay, great.
Yeah, I'm 14.
Cool. Well, you speak excellent English. Where did you learn English?
I learn English not in my school, because in school the teacher just teach us some small conversation, a little bit grammar, but not clearly. They just pass it, and a little bit listening. So I learned this accent, I learned this I learned this speak English at my extra classes.
Extra classes? Oh,
Yeah.
okay. Cool. And in your extra classes, is your teacher from Vietnam or a native speaker?
My teachers in extra classes is from Vietnam. At the beginning, I started learning English 3 years ago, and my teachers at that time, he just better than me about 3 years ago, just a little bit, because at that time, he just started find like he's started understand English, and he study with me.
Okay,
Yeah.
that's awesome. Well, your accent and your intonation are great, Lynn. Usually, with people from Vietnam, from what I've experienced, there's a heavy interference with the Vietnamese and the English, and the accent is very thick. But you're doing a great job with your accent.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, in Vietnam, like you said that you go to Saigon and when they're in the south, and in the south the accent of the people are different from in the north. So yeah, so when we speak English, I think the difference in from that.
Okay. So
Yeah.
you're in the north in like Hanoi?
I'm near it. I'm near Hanoi.
Near?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just outside a
Cool.
little
Very
bit.
cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Thank you.
So it's nice to meet you. And so if I return to Vietnam and I go to the north, what places would you recommend in the north part of Vietnam?
In the north, I recommend you to go to some beaches, okay, Halong Bay. Have you heard it before?
Let me see it. Let me see if Halong Bay. Yeah, I have heard of that.
There's a lot of mountain and it's very good.
Have you been there?
I like my my parents, he gave me some pictures about 5 years ago when they traveled, they visit this. I haven't traveled to go visit this yet, but I see there are many pictures that my father take. And at this summer vacation, I will visit this.
Oh, awesome. That's something very nice to look forward to.
Yes.
There they have really big limestone rocks, right?
Yes. Yes, many beautiful places. And Hoi An.
Hoi An? Oh, okay. I have not heard of Hoi An.
It's okay. Hoi An is like a quite popular places that foreigners travel, and yeah, I think it's great.
Is that a beach place also?
It's like I don't have no. It's like Old Square.
Old Square.
Like this. I write so I don't know how to write it. Is that right?
Old Spare. To be honest, Old Spare, I don't know what that is. I'm not
sure. Oh, yeah. Okay, I will find it.
Okay.
It, like, I heard it before. I don't know how to say it in Vietnamese. I'm sorry, in English. So, like, there's the full name of it. So, I will find it in the Google.
Okay.
Right now, I can't find it anywhere. Okay, just passed it. Yeah, you can take it in Google. It's very, you just need to type Hoi An in the Google and search it. Yeah, it's very beautiful. Cool. Yeah.
Thank you for the recommendations. That's great.
You're welcome.
So the area that you live is outside of the big city, so it's a smaller town.
Like I live in the next city near Hanoi. It's named Thái Nguyên, and I live in the countryside.
Ah, very nice. That's nice. So you have a little bit more peace and quiet.
Yes, I don't like the noise and in the city because I don't know. I think I'm suitable in a countryside more. So how about you? Do you suitable in a city or in the countryside?
I'm the same way as you. I prefer to be in Mother Nature, surrounded by trees and birds and wildlife and our natural settings. And I feel much more peace of mind when I'm in these areas. And I feel like I have better energy. And I sleep better, actually, when I'm in the countryside.
Yes. So I was like go to Hanoi, like 3 months ago. So when I overnight in Hanoi and when I sleep, just suddenly the motorbike is very loud, and I just wake up and what's wrong in our house? So it's kind of scary. And in Hanoi, if we don't have money, so we can't buy like the large house or like the average house for us. Like in Hanoi, I know some people, they live in a very small house, like apartment. So yeah, I don't like it. I like to live in the large house when we can play, we can do anything we want. So yeah, so I think I like countryside more.
I agree.
And
actually there have been some studies done in by the university very close to where I live in Seattle. And the studies show that people that live in big cities in general have higher anxiety and stress, and also higher levels of sickness and depression.
Yeah.
So like lots of negative energy in cities. I think it's the lifestyle that people live in big cities.
Yes, in the city, but is have many goods. Like in the city, we can't like contact with many excellent students. Where like I meet a student, she's learned in the city, and she says that in when we learn in a city, we can't go to many places that. Many good teachers, so we have a good quality to learn. I don't know how to say it. I'm just suddenly
Like
forget.
quality of education.
Yes, education. Yeah, so we have a good education for that. So yeah, it's kind of great. So the students in like, have you ever traveled to a board? Sorry, my brother. He shot.
Does he
Okay.
speak English?
Yes. He like. Right now he's seven. He's
Okay.
seven, and in the yesterday he has the chance to talk with a foreigner in complete too.
Oh, cool.
Just 3 minutes because he can speak longer, but I'm very proud of it.
Good, that's awesome.
Yeah, thank you. So, have you ever traveled to outside of America to teach?
Yes, actually, I know that I said I'm from Seattle, but actually, right now I live in Brazil. Have you ever heard of Brazil?
Yes, and like it's very famous of soccer, football, right?
Yeah,
Yeah, I know
exactly.
it. I know it. Yeah.
It's in South America.
Oh, yeah.
And right now it's 8:48 a.m. here in Brazil. What time is it in Vietnam?
It's 7 p.m. in
7 p.m.
Vietnam.
Okay.
Yeah, so it is dark now. Yeah,
Okay, cool.
so students in Brazil, how do they learn English?
Well, most of the public and private schools in Brazil teach English, but it's kind of the same as what you were mentioning, where the focus is kind of on grammar, and the
Yes.
students don't have very many opportunities to speak the language and to produce the
Yes.
language and practice. So there are independent English language schools.
Yes.
And many students will go to this independent language school after their normal school, so like at nighttime. And I actually work at nighttime. That's my main schedule. So during the daytime and morning, I like to be here on Cambly and speaking with people from all
Yes.
over the world.
Yes.
But yeah, there are a lot of people that speak okay here in Brazil. There are not too many native teachers like myself, so sometimes it's kind of difficult to learn a language when there are not many opportunities to practice, and also
Yes.
two, when the teaching quality is not as good. But yeah,
Right.
Brazil's been a great place. What about
Yes.
you? Have you ever traveled to a different place, a different country?
Not yet. I just travel some places in Vietnam only.
Okay.
So,
Where would you
yes.
like to go someday?
America.
Oh,
Yeah,
okay.
I really like
You're welcome
America.
anytime.
Yes, thank you. So it's very nice to meet you. My
Very
time is
nice to
running out.
meet you too, Lynn. And
Yes.
do you use this application every day?
Yes, I use it
Yes.
every day. Yes.
Okay.
So
Well,
I hope we
feel
can talk
free.
more.
Yeah, feel free to call me again a different time, or you can even make a reservation with me if you want. I would be more than happy to help you and to keep talking with you.
Yeah, thank you so much. So,
Okay.
yes.
You have a good
Have a
night,
nice
okay?
yeah, have a nice day. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.